Hello, I'm Alison Carr and I'm a playwright and I have written Quick Bright Things that is going to be on at the People's Theatre as part of the RSC Open Stages project in April. It's a new project from the Royal Shakespeare Company that they've set up to celebrate and develop amateur theatre. And theatre companies from all over the country were invited to submit ideas to produce their own Shakespeare-branded production, and the People's Theatre was selected to be one of the companies involved. The People's pitched an idea for the project to the RSC. The brief was quite wide that we were given, so you could either do a Shakespeare play, a play that existed that was inspired by Shakespeare or about Shakespeare, like Rosencrantz and Guildenstern or Dead, or you could write a brand new play or a brand new musical that took its inspiration from Shakespeare. I was approached, I was asked, which is always nice to be asked, by Tony Childs, who is directing the play and who's a long-time member of the People's. And he asked me if I was interested in us collaborating and pitching an idea to write a brand new play for the project. And that's what we've done. Quick Bright Things takes its inspiration from A Midsummer Night's Dream, particularly the character of Helena. So the play looks at Helena's life before, during and after the events that are in the Shakespeare play. So it's three short sections, three short scenes. The first one is a teenage Helena and her sort of teenage friendship with her best friend Hermia and her relationship with boys. And it's a very awkward teenage date where it's all very toe-curling and awful. Part two is the Shakespeare play, so condensed down into 20 minutes, where it's just the lovers, the four lovers in the forest. And part three is 20 years after the forest. It's a monologue with the Helena character, and we find out what her life has been like and how she has built a life with Demetrius, who, after the forest, is still in the clutches of the love potion that the fairies give him in the play. So he's essentially drugged to love Helena. So we find out, how do you live a life with somebody who is bewitched to be in love with you? Midsummer Night's Dream was the first Shakespeare play that I ever read. So I did it at school, Wickham Comp, with Mrs. Dolan in her English class. I think it was year 8 or 9, so we were quite young and we were quite nervous about studying Shakespeare for the first time. But Mrs. Dolan was a great teacher and she really just brought it alive, and it's always stayed with me as being one of my absolutely favourite Shakespeare plays. And particularly the Helena character is one that I always really enjoyed. So when it came to writing the play, I knew that I wanted to use that play as my springboard and to use Helena as my character that I wanted to look at, really. It's not, because each of the three parts of the play are very different. We wanted to present them in a very different way as well. So each section is going to be in a different part of the People's Theatre building. So we're going to be in the bar, we're going to be on the main stage, and we're going to be in the dressing rooms. So it'll be something very different for the audiences, and they'll get to see lots of different locations that they wouldn't normally get to see. Well, last year the People's hosted the AGM for the Little Theatre Guild. So all different amateur theatres, delegates from all over the country came to the People's Theatre for a long weekend of sort of events and skills sharing. And one of the things that they said time and again was how lucky the People's is to have this building. And I think when you've got something, you take it for granted. So they were saying, oh, you know, you've got this fantastic auditorium, these great rehearsal rooms, these bars, and they were really impressed by the facilities. So when it came to writing the play and thinking about how to do it, I thought, well, if you're going to do something different, you may as well do it full on different and just go for it. So let's celebrate the building, let's celebrate what the People's has got, and really give the audiences something that they haven't seen before. So, yes, you know, audiences who've been here may have sat in the auditorium and looked onto the stage, But for this, the audience are going to have the experience of standing on the stage and looking out into the auditorium. So they will see the view that the people's actors would normally get to see. And again, going backstage and under the stage and just all different areas that you wouldn't normally get. So it's just to really make it something new and hopefully quite special. As far as I'm aware, no. I've been sort of around and aware of the Peoples for about 6 years, and in that time I know they've not done anything like this before. I'm not sure about before that, but I don't think so. So the Promenade is very new, it's a new play, and also I think is a first, there's going to be two performances of the play a night rather than just one. So there's a 7:30 performance and a 8:15 performance. Because the audience numbers are going to be quite small. There'll only be 40 audience per show. So all in all, the whole thing is just something a bit new and a bit different for the Peoples. Quick Bright Things at the Peoples Theatre, part of the RSC Open Stages project, a brand new play that'll be on from the 17th to the 21st of April.